Tech overload. All of today's technology, from email to Facebook and smartphones, well, it can make your head spin.
All right, there is a way to end all the madness, though, and use all those distractions to climb the ladder of success. Channel 4 Action News anchor Sally Wagan is taking action for all of us tonight. All right.
Okay, guys, is it okay to send a thank you note by email?
I say absolutely not.
Sometimes.
More than sometimes, actually, guys. In many industries, the answer is yes. Social media have changed our workplace, but not as much as you think. We still interrupt ourselves at work about a third of the time, but now the interruptions are often digital.
And it shows you a big version of, like, these two pages.
Maya Designs on the South Side is the epitome of high tech. In fact, Maya stands for most advanced yet acceptable.
That's all about making sure that the technology does the things that it's good for, and the people do the things that they're good for.
Because it is a small open workspace, employees here are allowed to use their preferred form of communication.
You know how some people operate in terms of their email. Some people have big long lists in their inbox and they don't really get to them. So if you need them right now, you should walk over and go find them.
So what is your favorite form of communicating?
That's an interesting question. I don't know. I'm kind of partial to talking.
So was Socrates. The ancient Greek philosopher worried that writing would replace talking. Communications historian Brent Malin at Pitt says that humans have always worried about technology changes.
The telegraph would mean people would stop going to church because they could just stay at home and get their information. People should not have telephones, because if they do exactly this, they're going to be calling all the time. And so we're always going to have to answer people's telephone calls.
But today there are so many additional layers of communication. Even someone like the dean of the College of Engineering at Carnegie Mellon University is feeling pressed.
Since I have access to BlackBerry, iPad, my laptop, I do feel the urge, the need to respond. But every so often, I have to also control myself and not respond.
But recent data shows most people read email within a couple of minutes after it shows up. And that's inefficient, according to an expert on interruption.
You shouldn't, for example, have an alert on your email that tells you when you've got a new one coming in, because that then is a temptation to go look at it.
It used to be that if you wrote a letter, you know it's going to take some time to get a response. Now, when you see 12 emails in your inbox, you feel like, I better respond to that right now. That's because other people expect you to.
So Catherine Lamberton from the Katz Graduate School of Business advises being clear about how you use social media. Use a deliberate strategy for each kind.
LinkedIn is good for recruiting. Have your HR people use LinkedIn. That makes sense.
Facebook is good for meetings or brand awareness, so marketers and advertisers should focus here. Twitter can be used to link to other sites you're promoting. And texting, here's when not to text.
Anything that's complex, you don't want to text, right? Something that can be misunderstood easily, you don't want to text. Something that has high emotional content, you don't want to text.
One sign of social media overload, not being able to make a decision about what platform to use. Digital detox can help. You know what that is? That's digital detox.
Thank you.
But,
can he come back to me now?
Yes, he can.
Okay.
But if you do it,
yes,
you have to post, tweet, text, email, tell people that you're doing it, and then you won't worry about coming back to hundreds of things for you.
My palms are getting sweaty. Can I have my
they
stuff
call
back?
That, you know what? They call that
what
addiction.
Yes, and very nerdy, but that's okay. We love you anyway.
Thank you, Sally. Let me have my phone back now.
You're welcome.